Today, I'm going to add hours to your life. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today, I've got something really exciting for you. Actually, you might think it's totally lame, but I think it's really exciting. We're going to talk about keyboard shortcuts. I'm going to show you guys some of the commonly used ones and how to make your own. And below, we've got a link to our commonly used keyboard shortcut list. Well, why are we doing this? Well, the biggest thing that makes me fast in Photoshop is using keyboard shortcuts. When I watch other people do Photoshop and they're kind of like hunting and like kind of moving all around the screen and things like that, that's just taking up valuable time. And although it might not seem like it matters a lot, if you can save like a few minutes here and a few minutes there, eventually it's going to add up and you get more time of your life back because you can edit much, much faster. So creating keyboard shortcuts are gonna really help that out, and especially if you can create custom keyboard shortcuts to things that you do most common in Photoshop. So I'm gonna show you guys just a quick example of how I use keyboard shortcuts, and then we're gonna talk about how to create some custom ones. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop. I don't have a document open, and that's on purpose because I'm gonna create a new one by hitting Command N. By the way, anytime I say Command, if you guys are on a PC, it's gonna be Control. If I say Option, it's gonna be Alt for you, and Shift remains the same. So Command N creates a new document, and then you can just say, that looks good, and hit okay. For the most part, I work on my images in full screen mode. I like that they take up the entire screen. So you can get to that by hitting F. If you'd like that out of it, you can hit Shift F or F three times. Okay, so let's go to our full screen mode. Now, if you wanna move things around, hold down your space bar and click and move anywhere you want. I'm not even gonna use my Wacom tablet today. All of the tools over here on the left also have keyboard shortcuts to get to them. Things like on the top left, you have your marquee tool. M is your marquee tool. And you can see if you hover over it, it'll say elliptical marquee. There we go. And it'll have parentheses M. Now, if you'd like to go through, there are a couple different marquee tools. So if you want to kind of go through those, you can hold down the shift key and then hit M. And you can see that it's flipping through those. All right, let's say like L is our lasso tool, so you can hit L for there, and then hold shift and hit L a couple times. That's gonna kind of rotate through those. W is the wand tool, V is the move tool, C is the crop tool, J is the healing brush tool, S is the clone stamp tool, B is the brush tool, G is the gradient tool, E is the eraser tool. So all these things you can see, you can hit a button, and if you're here in the middle of working on your document, you don't have to like go back over here and kind of work on things. So those are some really big things that are gonna help save a lot of time. Let's go to our brush tool, and I'll talk about a couple of these keyboard shortcuts that are really gonna help save you some time as well. Now, it's gonna be Control and Option. If you guys are on a Mac, it's gonna be, it's gonna be Control and Alt if you guys are on a PC. Just hit those two buttons down and click, and if you drag left or the right, it's going to make your brush either larger or smaller. And if you drag up or down, it's gonna make your brush harder or softer. So some really great ways to control your brush size very easily. All right, let's do a couple of cool things. I'm gonna hit M for my marquee tool, and I'm going to create a little marquee. And then we're gonna fill this with a color. This is very handy. Filling selections with color on your layer masks is what I mostly use it for. So let's say you have a layer mask and you wanna make everything invisible, you can fill with either your foreground or background color. So let's hit the D key on our keyboard. D is going to bring up your default colors, which will always be black and white. So D for your default colors, your foreground color will be black, your background color will be white. If I wanna fill a selection with my foreground color, you hold down Option and hit Delete. If I wanna fill it with my background color, Command and hit Delete. Pretty cool, huh? All right, let's just fill the entire thing, Option Delete, with our foreground color. And then if I wanna invert that, which I do very frequently on layer mask, Command I will then invert it. So you can see you can do just about anything with a keyboard shortcut. Instead of going to invert like image, adjustments down here, then you gotta look for it. Oh, there it is, Command I to invert. Just quite a bit faster. Now, if you guys are not used to using keyboard shortcuts, you can find them here. Everything you see will actually have a keyboard shortcut if there already is a keyboard shortcut assigned to it. But we can take that a step further. Let's just say filter and blur. Let's say our Gaussian blur. I created a custom keyboard shortcut for my Gaussian blur because I use it quite frequently. So I'll show you guys how to do that right now. But right now, unless you've already done it, you do not have a custom keyboard shortcut for a Gaussian blur. So let's say I wanted to fill that with a color, Option Delete to fill with black. Command D to deselect. And then my keyboard shortcut for the Gaussian blur is Shift Option Command G, which brings up my Gaussian blur, and now I can go ahead and blur that. So you can see it just saves quite a bit of time. I use blurs all the time, and it's a good way to do it. Option Command Z will take a step back in time. So I'll show you guys how to do that same thing. You can create any keyboard shortcut that you'd like. Just go to Edit right over here, and then go down to where you see Keyboard Shortcuts, or you can hit Shift Option Command K. There we go. Here are our keyboard shortcuts, and they're really easy to create in Photoshop. They make it very easy for you. What we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and go to the blur. So we're going to go to Filter, and you could just basically scroll down to, you have your blur, and then you have your few different blurs, and right over here you can see Gaussian blur. Let's just go ahead and subtract that out. So this is basically how it's going to look on yours if you don't have one set up. So let's say Gaussian blur, we want to set up a keyboard shortcut. Well, literally all you do is hold down the keys in which you need to, those are going to be the keys that are going to create the keyboard shortcut. So in this case, we're going to hold down Shift, Option, Command, and hit G. And we'll say Accept. And then now our keyboard shortcut for the Gaussian blur is Shift, Option, Command, G. If you have other ones like Adaptive Wide Angle, Shift, Command, A, I've never used that in my life, but if that's one that you want, now they're listed here as well. Let's try another one. Let's just say we're going to go to File, and I want to go to, let's see, if I want to go to Save, let's say I don't even like the keyboard shortcut for Save. I want to make it my own. Well, let's click over here, and I'm going to hit Shift Command S. Now, what it's going to tell me is Shift Command S is already in use and will be removed from File Save As if accepted. Now, you can undo this change. You can say like, oh, okay, it's already in use. I don't want to use it up. Or you can just say, okay, I'll accept that and I'll go to accept the conflict. So now save is Shift Option Command S, and then just regular save as can be Command S. So if you want to switch those around, you can totally do that too. I don't like that, so I'm going to switch them back. Command S, accept to go to conflict, and then save as will be Shift Command S. There we go. So accept that as well. So a really great way to add keyboard shortcuts if you're not already using them. So a couple of them that I add, Shift Option Command G, we already talked about that one. That's a pretty good one for the Gaussian blur. Let's just hit cancel there. If I want to, let's just fill that with white. Shift Option Command N will create a new layer. That comes loaded by default. Let's go ahead and fill this. If I do want to crop to a certain area, which I do quite often, you can hold down the Command key, click on whatever's on a layer, and then set up the crop. And to do that, I don't have it set up on this computer. I have it set up on the one behind me. Let's set up crop. What do you say? We'll go to image, and then we'll go down here to crop. And I have that one set up as Shift Option Command C. I believe it's down here at the bottom. Okay, there we go. Shift Option Command C, and it will say it will be removed from content aware scale, which is okay because I don't ever use that. So we're going to say okay. So this is selected. Shift Option Command C will now crop to exactly what you have selected, which is very nice. All right, Option Command Z will undo that. The high pass filter I have set up, I use that for sharpening quite a bit. So that is set up to Shift Option Command H. There we go. We've added a high pass filter onto a circle, which makes it gray. Very nice. You can use it for sharpening. In this case, it really doesn't do much. And then delete will delete the layer you're currently on. So you don't have to like click it and drag it to the trash can. Shift Option Command N will create a new layer. Delete will create a deleted layer. it won't create anything. It's just going to delete your current layer that you have. So that's it, guys. Some of the keyboard shortcuts that I use quite frequently, and then how to create them. And then down below, we have a very extensive list of the keyboard shortcuts we use, as well as some really cool wallpapers that you guys can put on your computer. So if there are anything that I missed, guys, if you have some keyboard shortcuts that you use and love, make sure to leave them in a comment down below. Help everyone out. Help the community. Help the family. Help one another. And that's the end of the episode. Thanks so much, guys. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone. Photoshop now responds to audible shortcuts as well. When I clap my hand twice, it's going to be the keyboard shortcut to end this episode.